Good morning. Now that we've made the necessary introductions, we can really start to talk about the operation and functionality of the Siemens 840D operating version. As you know, Paolo was with me. Good morning, Paolo. Well, now we can start a new lesson on CNC, of course. The first thing to do when learning to use a new numerical control is to become familiar with the operator panel, which contains the alphanumeric keyboard, the screen, and the button panel with which the operator interacts with the numerical control and the machine. In the last few years, Siemens has made considerable progress on the development of the operator panel to make it increasingly functional and adaptable to the needs of operators and manufacturers of machines. Touchscreens have been introduced, and various configurations with different screen sizes have been developed. In fact, as the screen size changes, the panel also modifies to adapt to the new size. In addition to this, there is the possibility for the machine manufacturer to completely configure the operator panel to make it customized according to his needs. You're right, that's a fair concern, Paolo. But fortunately, even though the size of the screens may change or the machine manufacturers create their own custom panels, the nature of the control remains the same. And more importantly, so does the operation. So what we'll see from now on is the standard Siemens 840D operator panel. The manufacturers who have created their own custom panels will have changed the design or the position of the buttons, or in some cases made them software buttons. But the functionality and also their icons remain similar in most cases. The interface panel can be configured in various ways, but in any case, the buttons and functions will always be the same. They will simply be in different positions. Whatever the configuration of the panel is, we can identify three functional areas. The first is the screen area with its buttons for interacting with the horizontal and vertical soft keys of the numerical control. The second area concerns the Siemens keyboard, in which there is the alphanumeric keyboard and the keyboard for navigating the control with all the specific buttons of the Siemens control. Finally, we have the third area, the control panel. This area is where the operator interacts with the machine for all operational activities. It is from here that the operator determines what state to put the machine in, manual, MDI, or automatic. It is from here that he can move the axes and start or stop a program. In this part of the panel, you will also find all the buttons developed by the manufacturer to interact with the specific functions of the machine, such as manual coolant ignition, startup of the chip conveyor, or advanced functions designed by the manufacturer, such as clearing the remaining path or other functions. These three areas can have different configurations with different positions between them. Let's look at the most common configurations. The first setup we analyze is also the most common. The screen is of medium size, so the Siemens keyboard is placed next to the screen. For reasons of space, they have used an alphabetical keyboard, but it is very convenient because it's close to the screen. The hands move to the left to operate the soft keys on the screen and to the right on the keyboard very quickly because everything is very close together. The control panel is located below the screen. The second configuration is usually present when the screen starts to get bigger. The screen is placed at the top of the panel, just below the Siemens keyboard, which in this case is a QWERTY keyboard. And finally, below everything is the operator panel, which in most cases is also slightly detached. In the last setup, the main difference concerns the Siemens keyboard, which is detached from the screen and also positioned in horizontal mode or at a slight angle, so as to make writing the program easier by allowing the palm of the hands to rest on it while writing. The operator panel in this case will be located just below the screen. You're right, Paolo. Let's see how the panel is set up in the case of the Sinutrain simulator. First of all, remember that when configuring the machine, you can choose the screen size that best suits the size of your computer. During configuration of the new machine, or even when the machine has already been created, just right-click on the icon of the machine. In the menu that appears, select Settings. Once the machine configuration window is open, select the desired screen resolution that best suits your PC monitor. Once the simulator has been started up, you will find the buttons belonging to the Siemens keyboard on the right, while the standard Siemens operator panel is at the bottom, where the buttons relating to the manufacturer's functions are obviously missing. The QWERTY keyboard is also missing because, obviously, Sinutrain assumes that we are working with our computer. So, we will use the PC keyboard to edit text and numbers. If, for example, we are working with two monitors, it is possible to detach the Siemens control panel and the operator panel to have it in two separate windows and be able to place it where we prefer. To do this, click on the View menu and click on Split to Single Windows. At this point, to display the operator panel, click on Show Machine Control Panel and position the panel where you want it. To show the Siemens controls, click on Show Synumeric Operate Machine Control Panel and position it where you want it too. Let us now see how to move around in the control and the main keys to navigate the various windows. The most important button for browsing the various menus and windows of the control is the Menu Select button. The Menu Select button can be found at the bottom right of the screen, or for extended keyboards, together with the Siemens command set for the control navigation. Clicking on Menu Select will open the main menu, where we will have in order the machine soft key to display the machine status, with current position, active tool status, feed rate, and spindle status. Clicking on the parameter soft key takes you to the area dedicated to all the data required for setting up the machine. Therefore, the tool list, the work zero offset, and the window for checking the variables. Clicking on the program key shows the active program in editing, which is not necessarily the program selected to run automatically. The Program Manager soft key accesses the Program Management screen, where you can manage programs and folders in the NC memory, but also in other drives such as hard disk, USB, or network drives. Here, new programs are created, moved, or copied, or even selected for execution. The Diagnostic soft key is used to access the windows for displaying and managing alarms and messages. Finally, the Setup soft key is used to access the area mainly intended for maintenance and assistance activities, where all the machine parameters and control configuration parameters are located. If you are working on an NC with a touchscreen, you may find it useful to know that, just above the vertical soft key menu, there are two icons. One indicates the current position of the displayed window, while the other shows the operational status of the machine. Pressing on the first of the two icons will be the same as pressing on the Menu Select button, so clicking on it will also bring up the general menu. Well, we are almost done. Paolo, is everything clear to you? All right, so let's see if you really understood. To see the tool list, what should you click on? Good job. And to see the state of the machine? Awesome! And to see a program? That's right, very good, Paolo. Actually, there is also a shorter way, but available only with the extended keyboards. In the same group of keys where there is the Menu Select button, we find a Direct button. In fact, Siemens, in order to make the selection of the main windows even shorter, has created buttons that directly access the offset data, the Program window, the Program Management, and the Alarms. You're right, Paolo. In fact, Siemens has also thought about this. Since setup is not an area that needs to be accessed so frequently, and it would be better if this area is only accessed if you are really aware of what you're modifying, Siemens has rightfully not created a direct button.
Giustamente Siemens non ne ha creato un pulsante per accederci direttamente.
Well, that's it for this lesson. We'll see you in the next one.
Alla prossima lezione.